The World Health Organization has declared the 2019 novel coronavirus a global health emergency.
In the last 24 hours, we had the most cases in a single day since the outbreak started.
The virus, which originated from the city of Wuhan, China, has rapidly spread since the first report on December 31, 2019.
The spread of the novel coronavirus looks alarming. Cases have now been reported in 25 countries, but the epicenter remains in China.
The death toll has climbed to above 1,800, and more than 73,000 cases have been reported worldwide, primarily in China, where the World Health Organization says people are at a very high risk for infection. The coronavirus spreads through human-to-human transmission, primarily through coughing and sneezing.
If we invest in fighting at the epicenter, at the source, then the spread to other countries is minimal and also slow.
What caused the coronavirus? Experts believe it may have originated from the Hunan seafood wholesale market in Wuhan. The market, which is now closed temporarily, sells seafood as well as domestic and wild animals, including rats, wolf pups, snakes, squirrels, foxes, crocodiles, and civets. Chinese authorities placed a temporary ban on the wild animal trade in the wake of the outbreak in efforts to contain the spread of the disease. Under the ban, wildlife may not be transported or sold in any markets or online. Legal breeding centers are also under quarantine. Authorities said that they will severely investigate and punish anyone who breaches the ban. They set up a hotline where people can report violations. The ban will remain until the epidemic situation is lifted nationwide. A group of researchers from the country's top science and health organizations and universities have called upon the government to crack down on these markets, which they say allows for the spread of dangerous disease.
And the thought is that the virus was in a live animal, then it crossed into a human. But then what we found was that people were getting sick in terms of healthcare workers, in terms of family members that were looking after them, which now meant that the virus can pass from human to another human.
Loopholes in China's laws on wildlife trade exacerbate the risk. Enforcement on selling the meat of protected species and wild animals is not that strict, according to Qian Jiangming of the Anti-Poaching Squad. The volunteer-run group visits markets to report illegal wildlife sales. Ming said that the vendors tend to hide illegal offerings in back freezers. Despite restrictions, it is difficult to prosecute offenders without proof that the animals have been poached. Many groups are calling for more on-site inspections and restrictions or a total ban on wild animal markets, citing them as hazardous to human health. Christian Walzer, the executive director of the Wildlife Conservation Society's health program, believes there should be a global ban on wild animal markets. According to Walzer, zoonotic diseases, human diseases that originate in other species, account for a large share of infections. Mixing several species of wild animals in an unregulated market increases the risk of diseases mutating and spreading to humans, he told the Washington Post. If these markets persist and human consumption of illegal and unregulated wildlife persists, then the public will continue to face heightened risks from emerging new viruses, potentially more lethal, and the source of future pandemic spread. These are perfect laboratories for creating opportunities for these viruses to emerge. Coronavirus has spread quickly across the globe, as infected patients can transmit the disease to 25% of the people they encounter. The virus has a long incubation period and it can take up to 10 days to show signs of infection. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the most common symptoms include fever, cold, cough, muscle pain, and fatigue. CAT scans of the first 41 patients revealed pneumonia and lung abnormalities. While there is still much to understand about the coronavirus, the common flu is actually deadlier. The CDC estimates that there have been up to 26 million flu infections and more than 25,000 deaths since last October. The estimated basic reproduction number, shortened to R0, which represents the average number of people who will catch the disease from a single infected person, for coronavirus is 2.5. Because the number is greater than 1, it means that the disease will keep spreading. However, experts say that this number doesn't necessarily mean that people should panic. A higher number doesn't necessarily mean a worse disease. The R0 number for the flu hovers at an average of 1.3, yet it infects millions every year. The R0 number is an estimate of potential transmissibility, but it does not tell you how fast a disease will spread. Additionally, Some infected individuals may be super spreaders. A super spreader may infect 100 people, while 50 people infect no one. The coronavirus is still in its early days. Estimates are specific to its spread throughout Wuhan, and numbers are only a measure of the disease's potential. Other zoonotic diseases include the 2002 and 2003 outbreak of SARS, which stands for Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome.
SARS is becoming more aggressive, the number of victims expected to triple within weeks. Despite government assurances it's under control, doctors are no longer willing to hide their grave fears.
The disease infected more than 8,000 people and caused 774 deaths. It was traced to the consumption of wild animals in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou. SARS was linked to bats, which are known to harbor coronaviruses. But the species that caused the 2019 novel coronavirus remains unknown. Scientists have identified a 96.2% genetic similarity to a virus that afflicts bats, and a 79.5% similarity to the SARS virus. While experts first traced the origin of the coronavirus outbreak to the Hunan seafood wholesale market, a description of the clinical cases published in The Lancet puts forth other possibilities. According to the report, the first person to become ill was reported on December 1st and had no link to the market. 13 of the 41 cases that shortly followed had no connection to the market either. That's a big number, 13, with no link, said Daniel Lucy, an infectious disease specialist at the University of Georgetown. Reports from Chinese authorities and the World Health Organization said the earliest case of onset symptoms occurred on December 8th. They linked most cases to the seafood market. However, Lucy explained that if this is true, the first human infections must have occurred earlier due to the coronavirus's incubation period. The scenario of somebody being infected outside the market and then later bringing it to the market is one of the three scenarios we have considered that is still consistent with the data, said Christian Anderson, an evolutionary biologist at the Scripps Research Institute in San Diego. It's entirely plausible given our current data and knowledge. Experts are considering two other possibilities: a group of infected animals or a single animal that came into the marketplace. Lucy suggested that a retrospective analysis of blood from infected individuals, as well as animals, may reveal coronavirus's origin. The World Health Organization is advising people to take cautionary steps to prevent the spread of the coronavirus.
Frequently clean your hands by using an alcohol-based hand rub product, like a gel, or wash your hands with soap and water. When coughing and sneezing, cover your mouth and nose with flexed elbow like this, or use a tissue.
To date, there are no known medicines to prevent the coronavirus. Specific treatments are still being investigated. So, is eating other meat safe? Not exactly. While the coronavirus likely originated from wild animal meat, livestock meat such as pork, beef, and poultry also poses a number of risks to human health. Foodborne illnesses such as E. coli, a type of bacteria that resides in the lower intestines of warm-blooded animals, has been linked to undercooked ground meat products and raw milk. In April 2019, an E. coli outbreak linked to ground beef sickened 209 people in 10 states. In September 2018, Cargill, which supplies 22% of the U.S. domestic meat market, recalled 136,606 pounds made from the chunk portion of a cow carcass that may have been infected with E. coli. The CDC confirmed 18 cases in 4 states and 1 death. E. coli that originates from the fecal matter of animals can also contaminate produce if growing fields are close to cattle or dairy operations or manure or composting facilities. So, the 2018 E. coli outbreak that contaminated romaine lettuce, infecting 210 people in 36 states and killing 5, was likely caused by animal agriculture. In January 2020, another E. coli outbreak linked to romaine lettuce infected 167 people in 20 states. Leafy greens such as lettuce can become contaminated in the field by soil, contaminated water, animals, or improperly composted manure. Jeff Farber, director of the Canadian Research Institute for Food Safety and a professor at the University of Guelph in Ontario, told CNN after a 2018 outbreak. Lettuce can also be contaminated by bacteria during and after harvest from handling, storing, and transporting the produce. Other raw fruits and vegetables that have come into contact with feces from infected animals are another common source of infection. Salmonella, a bacterial infection that affects the intestinal tract, also spreads through animal products. In 2019, the CDC linked minor outbreaks to ground beef, frozen tuna, and ground turkey. In 2018, Salmonella cases were linked to ground turkey and beef, eggs, and chicken. It's not only connected to factory farming, cases were also linked to backyard poultry operations. Like the coronavirus and SARS, some other diseases spread from animals to humans, such as bovine spongiform encephalopathy, better known as mad cow disease. In the 1980s and again in the 2000s, mad cow disease made headlines. Known as Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease in humans, the fatal, degenerative brain disease was linked to cattle that were fed sheep remains infected by Scrapie. Animals sold in wildlife markets and factory farms are confined in close quarters, with little room to move or engage in natural behaviors. They often have no choice but to stand in their own feces, increasing the risk for disease to spread. Not only does meat pose a risk for infection, but it also has other health consequences. When heavy rain occurs, factory farm animal waste overflows from containment lagoons and can seep into local water supplies and croplands. Manure from lagoons releases air pollutants, including methane and hydrogen sulfide, which the National Institute for Occupational Safety cites as a leading cause of death. Factory farm workers are routinely exposed to harmful gases and particulate matter, and health effects include respiratory illnesses such as asthma and acute bronchitis, chronic pain, cardiovascular complications, and early death. Studies have shown an increase in a number of health issues for people living near factory farms, including increased risk of respiratory and nervous system illnesses, heart disease, metabolic disorders, and reproductive damage. As disease crises and health issues continue to surface, the need to address the treatment of animals is paramount. A global shift away from animal meat could save countless lives. That's it for today. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell. New videos every Tuesday and Friday.